Can I build a Next.js and Supabase app and deploy it to Vercel in less time than it takes this person to solve a Rubik's Cube? Well, let's find out. Starting from this Vercel template, I'm going to click deploy and use GitHub to store my repo. I've already authorized Vercel to use my GitHub account, so I just need to give it a name like Rubik's Cube, and I want my repo to be public. So I'm going to click create, and now I'm going to add a Supabase project to my Vercel account. I accept these and continue, and now I can choose where I want my database to be. I'm in Australia, so I'm going to pick Sydney and then scroll down and choose the free plan. We can keep this database name or name it something else and click create, and then I can connect this Supabase project to any of my environments in Vercel. I'm happy with those three, so I'm going to click connect, and we're done. Take that, Rubik's Cube person. All right, look, I've still got some time. Let's check out the project. So we can click this preview here to open up the deployed version of our application. And if we scroll down, we've got this next step section where it's telling us we need to set up redirect URLs to tell our Supabase project about our Vercel deployment for production. So if we go back to Vercel, we can click through to Vercel's dashboard from here. And then if we have a look under storage, we can see our Supabase project. And if we go into that one, we can open this up in the Supabase dashboard. And then under authentication and URL configuration, we want to add a new redirect URL for this first URL, so localhost over port 3000. So we can paste this one in here and add that URL. We then want another one for our Rubik's Cube URL. So this is our production instance on Vercel. So let's add that URL, and then one more for our production URL on Vercel, which also has our Vercel team URL. So let's start by pasting that in here, and then we can get our Vercel team URL from the Vercel dashboard and looking at the URL for our Vercel project, and it's this bit after vercel.com. So my team is Jon Meyers dash projects. So let's paste that one in here as our redirect URL and click add URL. And now if we go back to our Next.js project, we've set up these redirect URLs. So now we can sign up our first user. So this template comes with authentication all already wired up for us. So we can just click sign up and create a new account for John at supabase.com and my super secure password and click sign up. This is telling me to check my email for a verification link, which looks something like this. So let's confirm our email address actually exists. And we can see we're now signed in as that John user with all of our user information from Supabase, and our next steps have been automatically updated to create some tables and insert some data. So let's copy this code snippet and head back over to the Supabase dashboard, and then over in the SQL editor, we can paste this in and click run. Now we have a table called notes with some example notes in it, and we can see that over in the table editor, there is in fact a table called notes with some example notes. And back over in our Next.js application, the next steps are to query that data from our Next.js app. So let's head over to GitHub and search for our Rubik's Cube repository. And then we want to clone this project down locally. And then over in my terminal, I'm going to type git clone and then paste in that URL to clone down that repo locally. I can then change into it and open it up in VS Code. And we can see the project for that Next.js template. So let's create a new file or a new out for slash notes, and we're going to be creating a new page.tsx file. We can then paste in that code snippet from our Next.js application's next steps. So this is showing us how to create a Supabase client and then query those notes and display them on the page. So we can copy this one, paste it back in VS Code, give it a save, and then git add those changes and commit them with the message add notes page. We can then push those changes to origin main or create a PR if we're not just working with this demo application. And now if we go back over to the browser and go to the Vercel dashboard and look at our project's deployments, we'll see this is currently building a new deployment with that notes page. And when it's done, we can go to the production version of our Next.js application and navigate to slash notes and see each of those notes that have been pulled from that new table that we just created in our Supabase dashboard. So now that you have the full power of a Next.js application combined with everything in the Supabase stack, so AI tooling, auth, file storage, real-time subscriptions, what are you going to build? For some ideas, check out this video right here. We go through 10 new features that have recently dropped and will help you build in a weekend and scale to billions. But until next time, keep building cool stuff.